Hello and welcome to Auspol Explained. I'm David, your long curly haired host, and let's talk about how the Senate quota is determined. Okay, nerds, it's about time for me to face my fears and talk about my least favorite part of politics, the maths. How we determine winners for the Senate is a little bit complicated. The House of Representatives is easy, right? It's just counting preferences until someone gets more than half, and that's why, you know, they always use the House of Representatives when explaining preferential voting. The Senate gets to be a little bit more complicated because they're electing multiple senators for a state or territory, which is why I need to explain the maths. The Senate uses quotas and formulas and has transferable votes. It's a whole thing. But if you're patient, I'm gonna tell you how that works, and if it's also boring, don't blame me, it's maths. But I'll try and make this as engaging as possible. Also, naturally, all of this information is from the AEC website, and the link will be in the description so you can double check if I'm right, or if in the future this has become out of date, well, your friend, the Australian Electoral Commission, will be able to tell you up-to-date information at aec.gov.au. Okay, with that done, let's talk about the Senate. So, to win a Senate seat, a candidate needs a quota. A quota is calculated by dividing the total number of formal ballots by the number of senators to be elected, plus one, and then adding one to the result and ignoring any remainder. Basically, as a percentage, this means that a regular Senate half election for a state makes a quota approximately 14.28% because there are six seats up for grabs. A territory quota, on the other hand, is 33.3% because there are two seats up for grabs. During a double dissolution where all 12 seats for a state are up for grabs, the quota is 7.69%. which isn't half of a regular election because of the plus one. I've heard people say, oh, the quota is halved because the seats are doubled. No, because of the formulas. Everyone's forgotten about the formulas. Thank goodness you have me here to explain it. So the way you vote for Senate candidates is by either numbering at least six boxes above the line or at least 12 below the line. And then the AEC counts first preferences. Candidates who receive the quota or more are elected immediately. Good work. Next comes transferring the surplus. What do I mean by transferring the surplus? Well, if you've got a quota, then you've got a quota. Any more votes doesn't make you any more elected, don't be greedy. Surplus votes are transferred to candidates who were the second choice of voters on those ballot papers. They don't divide votes into votes that elected the candidate and surplus votes because that's impossible to determine. So they transfer those votes at a reduced rate. The transfer value is calculated by the surplus divided by the number of ballots held by the candidate. If that's still unclear to you, don't worry, I have a directly plagiarized example equation from the AEC. Let's imagine that candidate A gains 1 million votes. If the required quota was 600,000, the surplus would be 400,000.
That's maths.
The transfer value for candidate A's votes would be 400,000 divided by 1 million, which equals 0.4. Candidate A's 1 million ballot papers are then re-examined in order to determine the number of votes for second choice candidates. If candidate A's ballot papers gave 900,000 second preferences to candidate B, then candidate B would receive 360,000 votes. That's 900,000 multiplied by the transfer value of 0.4. These votes would be added to the votes candidate B received in the first count. If candidate B now has a quota thanks to candidate A's surplus votes, then they are elected. If candidate B now has any surplus votes themselves, a transfer value would be calculated and votes would be transferred in the same way. If all surplus votes from elected candidates are transferred, but there are still spots to fill, then we get to exclusion of unsuccessful candidates. The candidate with the least number of votes is excluded from the count, and the preferences on their ballot papers are distributed to those who survived. Oh, thank goodness. It's possible that someone can get a quota this way as well as surplus votes, and surplus votes are then transferred again before another exclusion happens. This repeats until all quotas are determined. Now, because you don't need to number every single box, that does mean that your ballot can exhaust itself. That means your preferences don't go to any candidate if none of them are popular enough to get a quota. Your preferences can't go anywhere that you don't mark them, so the more numbers you mark, the longer your ballot can be used in the count. There was a thing called group voting tickets that allowed parties to choose where your preferences went if you voted above the line, but that was abolished before 2016. It hasn't been used in over a decade for the Senate, so just simply don't worry about it. You choose your preferences, parties don't control them in any way whatsoever. Okay? Remember that. As ballots can be exhausted, this may result in a lack of votes to fill every single quota. Don't worry, if there is a spare spot left over at the end, then the remaining candidate with the highest vote count gets that final spot. Ta-da! So this is why on election night, while you're all gathered around the TV watching ABC News Live like me, you can see how they're constantly announcing the House of Representatives seat of blah 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 has been won by blah 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 and all these sort of things, and then you need to wait literally weeks until the Senate result is announced. It's because it's just very complicated and requires lots of counting. But now you understand it a little bit better, I hope. That's all from me. Thank you so much for tuning in. Don't forget to share, subscribe, and comment down below your favorite number. Also, thank you so much to my supporters on Patreon who give me my favorite kind of maths, additions to my bank account in the form of giving me monetary support for all the effort that I put into making sure that you have educational content to understand our parliament a little bit better. Thank you so much. I'll see you at the polls.